Removing vocal from a song. In this video, I'm comparing three programs which all offer a way to remove vocal from a song. iZotope's RX7 with its music rebalance function, Steinberg's Spectralayers 7 with its stems unmixing feature, and Audio Sorcery DMix Pro 2, which is a specialized program for unmix and vocal removing. Hi, I'm Marlon and welcome to the White Noise Studio. Each of these three tools remove vocal from music, but all in a different way. With iZotope's RX7, you'll have to use its standalone RX7 editor and select the Music Rebalance feature, where you can rebalance stems. And by changing the volume of a stem, and for this video it's the vocal, you can remove the vocal from the music. With Steinberg's Spectralayers 7, you can either work in the standalone program or use Spectralayers 7 in an Era 2 enabled DAW like Cubase. For this video, I'm working in the standalone version. To remove vocals, you'll have to select the Unmix Stems function, where you can select which stem needs to be separated from the music. In this case, we'll do the vocal only. Spectralayers then creates a separate stem for vocals and a separate stem for the rest of the music. By muting the vocal stem, you'll remove the vocal. But you also have the separated vocal available if you need that. Audio Sorcery DMix Pro 2 works the simplest of these three. You open a file and select here which one you want separated. In this case, the vocal. And here's what's different from the other two. DMix Pro works by uploading the file to a server, where it does its processing. So it's an online process. It uploads, gets in the queue, and then downloads the stems automatically. So the advantage is that it won't cost you any processing on your own computer. The downside is, when you have a slow connection, the time it takes to do the upload, processing and the download is totally dependent of your internet speed. After processing, you have two stems just like in Spectralayers. You can mute the vocal stem to remove the voice, and you also have the separated vocal in case you need it. DMix Pro 2 offers more ways to separate a vocal by using the melody editor, which can be used to manually focus the melody. But that one is less usable for completely removing a vocal. The standard way works best. That's a whole video by itself. I have prepared two pieces of audio to remove a vocal. One is a more open, moody sounding snippet of a song, and the other one is a part of a stoner rock song. I want to make it difficult for these programs. Let's start out with the moody, gloomy song snippet.
Swallow me, I'm nestled in your stomach now. You'll never get me out, believe me. Feed the parasite. Swallow me whole, parasite.
First, let's check iZotope RX7 Music Rebalance. I found the best setting for this audio track was Advanced Joint Algorithm with the sensitivity to max. After removing the vocal, you're left with this. You still hear some of the reverbed vocal in the background, and the bass is somewhat inconsistent in the attacks. When the vocal is gone, you hear the attack returning. Spectralayers 7 is next.
You'll never get.
The reverb is practically gone here and sounds better overall. Although the bass remains a tad inconsistent, but it's much better than with RX7. Although RX7 did remove this part better than Spectralayers. DMix Pro 2 does it like this. In here, you can hear that the vocal and reverb is removed, but some of the reverb returns after the vocal stops. in the second part, you hear some more artifacts happening in the background music. It does a way better job than RX7, but overall it's a bit less than Spectra Layers, but it's close. D-Mix Pro 2 also removes the entire vocal a tad better than Spectra Layers, and a lot better than RX7 in this audio example. Let's up the stakes and use the stoner rock song. Now, because this is a much more dense track, with the vocal being much more in the mix than separate, and having the vocal with a filtered effect in the first half, it will be very interesting to see how well these three programs can handle it. RX7 first. As you can hear, RX7 struggles a lot. In the second half it removes the vocal better, but in the first half it fails completely. Spectra Layer 7 is next. Spectra Layers does a much better job, but I still hear a little bit of vocal in both parts. In the second half, the vocal is removed a bit better. D-Mix Pro 2 now. With the automatic settings, D-Mix Pro 2 introduces more artifacts than Spectra Layers. It does remove the vocal a lot better than RX7, but not as good as Spectra Layers Pro 7. Let's use a different algorithm. With this one, it actually does a great job. You hear some parts of the vocal not being removed, but it's better like this. It's worth to experiment with D-Mix Pro, as you could hear. Spectra Layer 7 did the best job right out of the gate, but with some tweaking, you can also get some good results in D-Mix Pro 2. Okay, so I used two audio samples with fairly complex material. In the first one, there was a synth in the same range as the vocal, and there was also attack of the bass at the same range of the sibilance of the voice. You could hear that all three programs could remove the vocal in various degrees. Spectra Layers removed the vocal more thoroughly overall, but left a few spots of the original vocal. And D-Mix Pro 2 removed the vocal better overall. RX7 left more of the reverb in the track and introduced a more uneven response. The stoner rock sample was a lot more difficult to handle for all three programs. RX7 pretty much failed, and Spectra Layers did a great job by only leaving small traces of the original vocal. D-Mix Pro 2 introduced some artifacts but managed to remove most of the vocal. And if you want to experiment with the settings and want to comp several versions together, you can do a good job with D-Mix Pro 2. Now, which one will best for you if you want to remove vocals only? There are a few factors which you need to take into consideration. It's price and functionality. RX7 first. The music rebalance function is available in RX7 Standard, which normally costs $399, and RX Advanced, which costs $1,199. So for voice removal only, that is a bad deal. You do get all the other goodies of audio restoration, and that's why I got it. Now, I have seen videos where people removed the vocal with RX7 with great results, but as you could hear, with difficult material, it really struggled. Spectra Layers has the Elements and the Pro version. The vocal separation function, which you need to remove vocals, is in both. Spectralayer's Elements cost €79.99 and the Pro 7 cost €299 when bought separately. Both versions also offer more functions to work on your audio, so you buy more functionality than just the vocal removal as an added bonus. Now, Audio Sorcery has two versions. The DMix Pro 2, which comes in an annual subscription of €265.99, a monthly subscription of €26.99, or you can buy it for €583. The Essential version, which does all of the vocal removing stuff, costs €137.99 for a lifetime license. So it depends what you want. If you want to remove the vocal of a few tracks, you can look into the monthly subscription or buy the Essential version. You have the easy-to-use interface and the online processing of the vocal separation. This is also handy for batch processing. You can do it in the background when you have more work to do. Or you could use Spectralayer's Pro 7, which has a lot more functionalities, is a bit more complicated but does vocal removing really well. The choices. I would suggest downloading trials for all three of them and see which one works best for the audio you want to use it for. That is the best way. What's also important is to subscribe to this channel and like this video. Check out the video displayed on screen right now if you want to know more about vocal processing. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!